As an editor myself, most of my work goes towards making sure that the edit is as invisible as possible. The only time you should notice an edit is when it is bad. Every dialogue, every musical note, all the sound design and crossfades should melt into each other in a way that by the time the viewer checks their time, the video is already over. It's here we editors walk this paradoxical line, where we want the edit to be both invisible and have the maximum emotional impact. Now, there are a lot of great editors who have worked for many years without any recognition. It is rare to see an editor rise to a level of fame. And it is here when I am asked who I think is the best editor in the whole world. There is only one name that comes forward.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes.
वो बाहर कैजुअलिटी में कोई मरने की हालत में रहा तो उसको फॉर्म भरना जरूरी है क्या?
The success of Rajkumar Hirani's films comes down to a number of things, including writing his own screenplays, choosing strong moralities, his excellent casting and use of background music.
कौन सा नाम से बुलाता है? मामू.
ए मामू. चलना हटना ए.
But none differentiate him more than his editing style. Indeed, it is so strong that you could wake up from a 10-year coma, unknowingly watch one of his movies, and immediately recognize the unique style that cannot be replicated, unlike a visual aesthetic. The reason Rajkumar Hirani is able to create these perfectly paced movies is because he started as an editor. And even today, if you hear him talk about it, you can tell what his favorite part of filmmaking is.
But editing is a process which I invariably enjoy. Because,
okay, the most.
Because there are no dark days in that, there are no dealing with 500 people on the sets, that you sit alone in your room, lock the room, nobody comes and you see a film emerging. So that's very meditative for me, 2-3 months I sit in.
Editing comes down to two parts, moment to moment, i.e. momentary editing.
Hey papa, juice piyo na.
Or scene to scene, i.e. structural editing. Rajkumar Hirani's strength lies in not only making movies that have amazing momentary editing, but also how he structures his movies. And they are worth taking a look at in their own individual videos.
Papa?
One of the things you notice with Rajkumar Hirani's films is that you can pick up any of his movies at any point. There's never a need to worry about skipping to the best parts, because almost every scene is equally entertaining. Which mostly comes down to his philosophy of LCD.
So your idea is that every scene should be either, we call it an LCD principle, that either it should make you laugh, it should make you cry, or it should be dramatic enough.
One of the things I noticed on the opening of his very first movie, Munna Bhai MBBS, the entire scene from the first shot to the abduction acts as a mini movie in itself, from the inciting incident to growing obstacles to climax and resolution. Almost any scene in the movie can be put into this category. We start with an introduction.
Hello, Zaheer.
An inciting incident.
I think tumhe stomach cancer hai.
Growing obstacles.
Sare kaam khatam kar lo. Aadhe din mein.
A midpoint collision.
Theek ho jayega sab. Kyun pareshan kar rahe? Chhodiye.
Rising action as the stakes get high.
Dekh, life mein jab time kam rehta na, double jeene ka double.
A climax. And conclusion. This is the reason you almost get swept up into a Rajkumar Hirani movie when you land on it.
Your time starts.
The editing remains subservient to the story.
Now,
take for example the music we talked about earlier. Almost every single background track emanates from a person as if an extension of their emotions. But as often as possible, stops with the physical sound in the movie world.
Okay.
My own daughter.
The effect of this editing technique is subtle, but it accumulates. Your subconscious starts registering the emotions with these musical leitmotifs. Or the sounds associated with the people, places or ideas. This subconscious registration is something that most editors are obsessed with.
I don't cut from what I call knowledge. I have to come in tune, I have to feel it.
And it shows the way Hirani edits a movie, who started out his career as an editor in 2000 with the movie Mission Kashmir. A particular signature of a Raju Hirani movie is the rhythm of the scene as well as the moment. As much as the movie itself and its scenes follow the conventional story arc structure, so do the moments. Every scene has its moments built up with shorter and shorter cuts as they reach the climax.
Sharmati hai, Dr. Sharma.
This is one thing Raju Hirani knows. Every time you cut, the subconscious tries to find a reason why there was a cut. That is why he often forgoes spatio-temporal relations to maintain emotional beats. Like immediately cutting to this guy hanging off the roof instead of showing how he got manhandled to this point. Or slowing down the footage for the dialogue to catch up, even if the video looks choppy. Hirani is virtually obsessed with rhythm. You can tell from his interviews where he always talks about editing and in particular storyboarding his scenes in advance.
I still storyboard actually. I never till date go on the sets without.
Now storyboards are nothing new. They're comic book panel like drawings done in pre-production of a movie to keep the production running and clear up any confusion. But less often can storyboards be used to pre-plan emotional beats and rhythm of a movie, such as Parasite, a movie which almost entirely relied upon storyboarding instead of coverage to get the tempo needed just right for Bong Joon-ho, who wanted to shoot the movie without almost any coverage, a cinematic term for throwing around as many cameras as possible while shooting a scene and finding the movie in the process of the edit, an increasing phenomenon that has given us disasters like the 2016 Suicide Squad.
Rock steady.
For Rajkumar Hirani, storyboarding is what it takes for a scene to go from serious to comedic in a few seconds.
Yes.
But I still think like an editor when I'm shooting. When a scene is done, I can actually close my eyes and I can see the film. It flows like that. Which sometimes I think is a hindrance because a lot of people actually shoot the entire scene. Say, cover kar lo, phir dekhenge.
Now, this is mostly guesswork, but you can tell that Hirani likes to use both coverage in scenes of less drama and storyboard around scenes that have a very high dramatic value. This allows him to get the tempo just right to make these bold turns in tone every few seconds.
Phir kya? Agle din apne mohalle mein.
Aishwarya!
And I think his skill is perfectly distilled in this scene.
Again, going back to that carom board scene, I don't think we could have shot that scene if I had not storyboarded. Budget constraints, everything was there, and now Sanju that time didn't want to shoot nights. So there were like 5-6 different actors, and every day I used to get one actor. So I did an extensive storyboard saying what is the, divided into sections. Section 1, old man, the carom board is set up. Section 2, old man gets up and walks. Section 3, juice is placed. So every evening for 2 hours we would take out the...
And just follow it.
And just follow one actor. One day is only Jimmy. So we'll finish all Jimmy shots. So there was full confusion. Nobody was knowing what is happening. And I was to set up the camera and Rajesh would come to me and say, sir, wo bahar Dadaji bol rahe hain, andar pata nahi director kya kar raha hai. ये रोज कैरम बोर्ड लगाता है, कुछ कैरम बोर्ड के कुछ शॉट लेता है, कट कट करता है, क्या सीन हो रहा है पता ही नहीं चल रहा
है.
दावरा जी इज योर प्रोडक्शन हेड. बट हैट्स ऑफ टू हिम, ही केम बैक आफ्टर द फिल्म गॉट मेड एंड ही सॉ द सीन एंड ही सेड, सर अभी समझ में आया आप क्या कर रहे थे.
पापा Joyo, very nice shot, Papa.
Storyboarding is the biggest secret weapon in Rajkumar Hirani's arsenal. Along with his sense of rhythm, with the way dialogue and scenes should be cut, it is what allows him to pull off dramatic shifts in tonality in his scene as Hirani's unique position as the scriptwriter, director, and editor. He has complete control over how he can envision a scene and have it delivered to the audience with uncompromising finesse that is unique to only and only him. And tell stories that only he can.
आज बाप की हसरत भी पूरी कर दे.
And on that note, I'm gonna leave you with my favorite moment of subtle editing. Let's see if you can notice it.
तुम student हो?
Entry के exam में top किया ला अपुन ने. Class किधर है? हेलो.
हे Hey, thanks for watching, guys. This was about momentary editing, and next one is going to be our structural editing. This is part one of two. So be sure to stick around for that, and I hope to see you guys in the next one, and hope you guys liked it.